Hi guys, so this is our part two series on how you can use SAS in your Visual Studio Code. If you want to learn more on how you can integrate SAS in your VS, feel free to check my video about how to install SAS in Visual Studio. It's only 5 minutes, I think less than 5 minutes, or it's only 2 minutes long. I'm going to add an index.html and I'll add an HTML boilerplate. Now we will add a, let's say maybe style that CSS stand for SAS. Always have a installed live SAS compiler and the live server if you are doing development to expedite your production. So yeah, let's go back to the Explorer. So we have the index.html and we also have a style.sass, style.css. Now I'm gonna add a import linked. So this one, style.css, and I will add a folder called this one, sass. Now, can configure that settings by going to the gear icon and then click that settings option and then go to the extension and look for the extension called Live SAS Compiler. Okay, and then there is an option in here that is called Live SAS Compile Setting. So it will generate this by default, and it's located here. That format is in expanded, but we have other formats that we can use later, so I'll explain it later with you. So format is expanded, and then the extension, what kind of extensions you want to generate every time you click the watch SAS. So by default it will generate a style.css, but we can also use other extension, I believe, not so sure, but let's just check their page. And the Savepath. So by default there's no any path in here, that's why it just generate to our root directory, which is in the SAS folder that we create. Now we want, so let's try to do, I have some code in here. So if we use this part, by the way, if you find my video helpful, feel free to subscribe to my channel, click that subscribe button and that like, thumbs up, and the bell notification if you want to receive new videos from me. Now it's already running, and I'll go back to my CSS, to my desktop. You will see in here that there is a CSS folder that automatically generated. Now let's say if you don't want to be in the separate places, I want the CSS folder inside the SAS because I want all of my projects inside the SAS. So what you can do is, let's replace this code. So let's go back to the settings area. Okay, if you're confused where you can locate this one, just click this this settings and then click this one, settings. Okay, and then you click this settings.json. So you will able to see this part. Okay, now I don't want to generate a new folder outside my CSS, outside my SAS folder. So how you can do that? Then let's control S and let's try to watch. Okay, as you can see, it is already in the folder because we are we just target the root using the backslash thing. Okay, this one, and then we are targeting the CSS folder. So this code is the path for the CSS folder, but if you use this kind of code, it is outside our folder. So this one relatively means it's in the desktop area. Okay, now as you notice in here, we have, there is a style.css that map. If you want that to disabled, so by default it is enabled, so it is true by default. So if you want that to be disabled, you can go if you don't want the map to be compiled in CSS. By default, it is set to true. If you click that one, it will automatically generate this code, or you can copy this code and put it into your settings, that JSON. So we already set that by default. So I'll try to control S again, and then I will remove this style.css. Let's see if there's still a map being generated. So let's click the refreshed, watch SAS, and you'll see that the map is already gone. Okay, so that's the case. If you want to disable the map, then simply copy this code to and click and use the false if you don't want to generate the .map extension. Now I went to their official page and they have this kind of feature, so live SAS, and then they also have for the expanded. So they have this kind of, this one expanded is the default. Now if you want it to be in compress mode, like in a lightweight mode, we can also do that. So there's also an extension, so instead of CSS, you can also generate a min.css. So how we can do that? Let's try to open this, let's try to copy this code. Okay, I'm gonna copy that code, and I will use a compress, because I want the server read the min CSS. So I'm gonna use compress, and then the extension would be min.css. Okay, and then I will add another a folder which means min CSS. So, or let's like that. So min CSS. There is an error. So let's run for a simple, this one is a SAS file. So let's try to copy this HTML code in here and put it on our body section. And I will add this SAS here, and then I'll put it in here. Oh, there is an empty. So let's try to put a color red, just for example, and then save it. So currently this folder is empty. But again, if you already generated the compiled CSS version, no need for you to delete that one, because it will automatically generate, update or overwrite every time you click the watch SAS. So now let's click the watch SAS. And as you can see here, the style.css and the style min.css automatically generated. Now let's open our live server. And you'll see that, I mean, it's working. Now, if I go to my link.html header in here, I've used the default. I've used the expand. So best practices to when you are linking a CSS file, if you want to improve your speed load, I highly recommended that you use a minified version. So you attach the minified versions if you want, but if you still want to use the default one or the expanded, then yeah, we can choose this. So there's also other, let's go back to the official site. They also have this nested thing. I don't think this is necessary. So let's try to use this compact. I don't think the nested is the best practices. So let's just try to use compact and see how it looks. And for the production mode, you need really need to minify your style.css, or it's highly recommend to minify your style.css to improve your bandwidth, or to improve your to make your website, or to make your it's highly recommended to use minified version to make the website lightweight as possible. So yeah, I hope this has been helpful, guys. Let me know if you find this helpful, And comment down below if you have other tutorials on the next SaaS topic. And again, it's me, Bookworm Heads.